currently at Lake Keith's Park, a very secluded park. But if you ever want to run and get some exercise in, this is the place to go. You have a place to have a party and a playground. But today I'm just going to stroll and get some exercise in. You might hear a little singing too because I have my earphones on. Well, I'm still learning how to work this camera. So I think this is the start of the wilderness part of the park. Whoa. Nice houses. I would love to live next to a park. I would have brought my dogs, but I don't think I could film with them at the same time. Looks like they're fishing. Look at that house, it's beautiful. It's a beautiful day. Again, this is Columbus, Georgia, Lake Keith Park. As you can see, no one's here because it's, I don't think many people know about this place. I bet those houses are a little bit more expensive because they back up to a park. But I would need an alarm system for sure. Ali. So I think it's the trail is like at least a mile and a half, or at least shorter than 2 miles. That place over there, it's actually floods when it rains really bad. It hasn't rained a long time. Well, it's like a creek. Over this shallow bridge. Yeah. See the lake off in the distance, it's very beautiful. A lot of duck species. The old me would try to go through there, but I'm pretty sure it's muddy. This is actually peaceful. My dog would have dug a hole and got out of that fence. Look at the Canadian goose. Oh, squirrel. He doesn't seem to be. Oh, never mind. One and a half mile. I don't believe I started at the actual starting part. Very beautiful. Hi. Huh? Yes. I didn't want to get her face on me. Somebody built this, which is very neat because the trail gets washed away into the lake. So whoever did this is pretty smart. Wanda. There's the bathroom, and here's a little place to grill around the other entrance. I'm gonna go down here and see if I could get a closer shot of the lake. Oh, look, somebody planted some flowers. Some kind of rock structure. Usually they're not scared of people. People come out here and feed them. I think a lot of people come out here to just on their lunch break just to eat. Oh, look! I don't know what kind of bird that was. Yeah, I don't know. I would say robin, but I'm probably wrong. a nice, I think that's a new chair. Park Beautification and Conservation by Heath Cooper Rigdon. Cooperation with Muskogee County and the Bull Creek Watershed Development, number 28, adopted in 1961 by the Evergreen Garden Club. In the springtime, there's azaleas and flowers around this rock structure. I have no idea what that rock structure is in the middle, but art is art. So this is, I think this entrance is more hidden than the other entrance, because there's actually, you have to go through a neighborhood to get to this entrance. That's why I say it's so secluded. But if you go to Google Maps, you can find it. And I love maps. I brought my sister and my niece here. That's the entrance. A mile and 3/4. Oh, look at that treehouse. Wouldn't I kill to have that as a kid? Fake love, love. This is like a dead end. two suckers. This says start our Osborne Autumn Honorary Trail. Like, it's winter now, but I'm pretty sure people planted a lot of azaleas and different flowers around here and made it pretty. So that trail ahead goes below the dam, but we're going on top of the dam for better views. And it's spring and summertime. It can get, the grass can get pretty high up here. And I don't come up here because snakes or anything could be in there. When the city doesn't cut the grass. You see the abandoned neighborhood pool down there? It would have been nice if they could have kept it going. Uh-oh, look at the dog. You can't get me. But I think you can still have a barbecue or whatever down there. And those are abandoned tennis court. I say abandoned because it looks pretty bad. And we're on top of the dam. This is Watershed Reservoir 29. I think this is Windsor neighborhood. It's so beautiful. Great place for a stroll, that's for sure. In the spring, you can see the air show from the airport around March, standing right here. And Bull Creek goes all the way to the Chattahoochee River. So if you keep straight, you'll be in the Windsor Park area neighborhood. It's very nice. On the north side of the airport. Those people still got their Christmas decoration up. Now I'm going down. I used to run this entire thing. When the lake gets too high, this trail is flooded. And it's allowed to flood all the way back there. Little bitty fish. You see the fish just running away. this is a bat. I don't know if I really care for bats though. Uh-oh, fish, fish. How neat is that? I think somebody put those out there. Have no idea what the bird species are. But it's cool for the bird watchers. Somebody's walking their dog. Okay. Marco. They got a nice little path to their house. This is beautiful. I would love to live close, but I would have to worry about security. I think the park is closed at 9, so nobody should really be back here. Well, that's neat. I'm pretty sure that's the pool. We're on the west side of the park, or west side of the lake. So beautiful trees. Thank you.
No.
Yep.
Can you see all those ducks?
Yeah.
We lured them in with bread.
And yeah.
So we're out of bread.
You're out of bread?
We lost the bread.
That's cool. I don't think they're afraid of people, though.
They're not. We can hear them pretty much all day.
Huh?
Even them pretty much.
Yeah. Good place to bring your kids. But yeah, I don't, those are, people feed the birds so much that they're not even afraid of people. And these guys walk right in the middle of the road too, in a line. You have to wait until they move out of the way. But if you love nature, you'll let them be. Awesome. Oh boy. That's what I need to be doing, running. It's weird how these tree stumps come out the ground like this. I'm gonna have to look up why they do that. These little stubs. I hope I'm not stepping on them. Oh look, some more birds. Goose. Look, they ain't even scared. These are different species of bird. I don't know if they're sleeping or what. But he's very pretty. Might be a male or a female. He's looking at me. He's like, keep your distance, sir. Gotta be where the tree is trying to grow up, survive the water. I don't know, but it's very cool. Probably to survive the flood that happens. Interesting. What's love and living is well. I forgot I was filming. I would love to have that house, that pool, and a new slide. Hmm? I'm the one that's alive in this world. All that is flooded. Last time I was here. Hi. Weird. I wonder why that's taped off. Says warning. Or they must have just planted something. They say curiosity kills the cat, but I'm not a cat. It's probably where birds bury themselves. I don't know. Who knows? I'm just fine. Fine, fine, fine. Well, yes, sir. I'm okay. I'm fine. I'm fine. Flood. Whoa. I do my thing. I love my stuff. Blah. They're talking. They're talking. They're talking. Better. Look at the fishes. Always come here. Oh no, are they brim? Have no idea what you are, but I see y'all everywhere. Good place to fish, or this is where they be eating. Hey. Well. Gonna walk a little bit further and then turn back around. This has been a beautiful day. This is Blanchard Elementary School. Alright, I'm turning right here. Oh, oh, oh. Goes to the street. Oh, 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 dear. I'm learning how to love myself. See, nobody would know coming from that entrance. There's a park back here. Unless you live back here. Well, I enjoyed this walk. Yeah, it says hours are till 9 p.m., so there shouldn't be anyone in here. Welcome to Heath Park. I'm pretty sure I did 2 miles. But everyone, thanks for viewing my video. Like, comment, subscribe. Have an awesome day. So.